Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Allison and I'm going into my senior year of college at the University of North Texas, majoring in fashion merchandising. If you're new, definitely leave a comment down below and introduce yourself. So my kitten is literally right next to the camera. If I don't give him attention for like 5 seconds, he just ruins everything, including every plant and all my pompous and everything. If you're new here, definitely introduce yourself down below. I love getting to know you guys. Let me know how you found my channel. Without further ado, today's video is going to be my nighttime routine. This is something I've kind of been trying to nail down within the last couple months. It definitely isn't the same every day. It varies based on my work schedule and the things that I have going on that day, but I do try to incorporate specific things into my nighttime routine regardless of what time I'm going to sleep or what I have going on that evening. I just have these non-negotiables that I definitely want to share with you guys. Also, you'll notice in this video that I eat dinner pretty early. So this isn't always the case, but if I'm off work at this time or I have been at home all day, I usually eat dinner around 5:15, 5:30. I start cooking it around like 4:50-ish. And I do this because one, I don't like to rush through making my dinner. I really like cooking and I find that if I'm starving when I start cooking, it just never really ends well because I'm in a rush. So I usually start when I'm just starting to get hungry. That way I can enjoy the cooking process because it is something that I really do enjoy. And second reason why I eat dinner so early is because I go to sleep really early. So this is kind of a somewhat new thing I've incorporated into my lifestyle, but I wake up around 6 to 6:30 every single day now. If you watch my vlogs, you know I suffer with anxiety, and just waking up early and going to sleep early is really beneficial to me. So you'll also see that in this video, but I hope you guys enjoy it. I also made a new intro, which you probably already saw. So let me know what you think of it down below. I worked very hard on it, and let's get into the video. Good week so far. Happy Monday if you're listening on the day this comes out.
I said I have been watching Lindsay since the paper.
When it comes to winding down for the night, I like to light some Palo Santo, some sage, and watch a little bit of YouTube just to ease my mind, allow me to disconnect a little bit. I also like to light all the candles in my living room, kind of just create a zen vibe. Showering at night is definitely a non-negotiable for me. This just helps me to relax. I take off my makeup with some coconut oil. And for cleanser, I've been using the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cleanser. After that, I get out of the shower and brush my teeth. After brushing my teeth, I get right in with my nighttime skincare routine. These are some of my favorite products that I use at night. It definitely changes depending on my problem areas on my skin, but these have been my favorite lately.
and then I get into bed and read. Right now I'm rereading The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F, and this is one of my favorite books, and I always come back to it when I just need to change my headspace about my current life situations and just, you know, be humble and grounded. So I'm just cuddling with my cat Marlo and reading my book in bed, drinking a lot of water. I drink so much water at night, and just decompressing and relaxing. By this time, it's usually anywhere between 8:30 p.m. and 9:30 p.m. It kind of just ranges depending on the night, but this is basically my nighttime routine. This is what I've been doing recently, and it's really been working for me. Let me know your nighttime non-negotiables down below, and like and subscribe this video if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.